Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. For my presentation is the implementation of trade facilitation of perishable goods in Thailand. As you, Thailand is an agriculture exporting country, so the government give would like to facilitate the agriculture trade with international trade. So in 2004, we set up the, we call POSSEC, Perishable One-Stop Service Export Center, or POSSEC. It was managed by the private company that located in, we call Talat Thai, that is the wholesale market for agriculture product market. In is about 50 kilometers from here to Talat Thai. At that time, the government asked or request all the government agency that relate with issuing all the document for export to work there. To facilitate the work for export, such as Department of Agriculture that I work with. So we issue phytosanitary certificate at that place, and also with the Department of Foreign Trade that can issue certificate of origin and custom that can release. And at that time, I think they use EDI system to release the good from our country. To do the custom document. The objective of the government to facilitate perishable good, that is because the government have the policy to promote the establishment of agricultural export center for vegetable, fruit, ornamental plants, and agricultural products. As we export a lot of this, so the government want to facilitate because it's easy to deteriorate and to prepare the agriculture sector for international free trade and to facilitate the exporter on agriculture product inspection and issuance of related documents from relevant governmental agency. And the agricultural product pass the inspection form. This center could be export directly. No need to do inspection at the airport. But a few years after that, there is something happened because we transfer to the airport from Don Mueang Airport to Suvarnabhumi Airport. That when you arrive, you will arrive at Suvarnabhumi Airport in 2006. And also with the SPS issue is the it's become very important for international trade for agricultural product. And also with the inspection, in some importing country, they have the condition for inspect that we have to inspect. The officer have to inspect at the packing house. So in that place, cannot we will not use the POSSEC in Talat Thai. And also with the product should be from certified farm, placing importance of testability of the product. And some country require inspection to be conducted by both Thai officer and their own officer. And I will show you soon. The POSSEC incur a higher cost for transportation as exporters need to transport their product to POSSEC for inspection before going to the airport for export. And as I mentioned, that Suvarnabhumi Airport was operate in 2006. So all the permit governmental agency dealing with export product can do their activity at Suvarnabhumi Airport, free zone. So the process is not work anymore. When we transfer to Suvarnabhumi Airport, since we export a lot of perishable goods such as fruit, tropical fruit and vegetable, at that time we the airport would like to set up the warehouse for export for inspection as a process that we used to have in Talat Thai, but at that time we have not yet construct. So the exporter bring their good, their commodity at to the airport, and there is a very, what you call, traffic jam, or there is no, the facility is not ready enough to be worked. So the government and the private sector have to sit up and talk together that they have to solve the problem. So there is one free zone, warehouse in the free zone that is have a air condition and warehouse, and that is easy to go and to load one time load. So the private sector asked the government to use that warehouse to be this one to be the warehouse for export in the free zone. Normally, in a theoretically free zone, we will not allow to do any activity in the free zone. But in this case, we allow because we export a lot and it's more convenient. And the government, the custom department have to allow to be exported, to use a warehouse at the free zone. So this is the warehouse at the free zone. Do you see that it's convenient? The truck can come and load there, and one time loading. Yes, and this they spread for the box for our inspector to select to do sampling. And this is our officer that we work there, we have office there. Yeah, sampling. We export a lot of vegetable to EU country, to China, to Hong Kong, to Singapore. Yeah. This is our perishable, our product for Thai restaurant in other country. And we provide inspection at the warehouse. One corner in the warehouse is our inspection area. Yes. And this is also with orchid. We export a lot of orchid also. And that is for airport, Suvarnabhumi Airport. That is a airport that we export by air. But in some case, we have we export fruit by sea container, and we have bilateral agreement between Thai government and other government importing country, such as we use vapor heat treatment for mango to Japan, so we have to work with the Japanese inspector in the warehouse. So we will not inspect at the airport or seaport. So we have to inspect at the warehouse together. This is a VHT facility to do vapor heat treatment. Mango. This is the Japanese inspector, so they have to inspect with our Thai inspector at the warehouse for VHT, and before issuing phytosanitary certificate, we have to sign together. And after that, we seal, and so when they arrive at the port of the port, so no need to inspect anymore, and the custom have to be facilitated by clean line. this is for co-treatment to our lychee and longan to Australia and New Zealand to measure the temperature inside the fruit. And this is a container, refrigerator container. The container have to be sealed. So no need to do any document or any inspection at the port. Bitternut to Taiwan. We do fumigation at the warehouse of the exporter. And we sign together with the Taiwanese plant quarantine inspector. This is the fruit that we export to USA that it have to pass irradiation program. So both Thai and USDA inspectors inspect together at the warehouse before export and seen. So no need to do anything at the airport or seaport. This is a USDA inspector. You see, we have to, every agreement, when we do agreement, they have to be, it have to be sealed before export. So it not open along the way. And also Thai, we export a lot to China, and we have some we have protocol with China. There are two protocols that we export our product by with AQSIQ to do the process before export. How can we do? We have to register the fruit have to be come from the orchard that registered by the Department of Agriculture, and they have to pack in the packing house that it have to register by our department. And after that, we have to inspect at the warehouse for the exporter warehouse and seal. And this is the route that go to the China through route number 9 and route number 3. Route number 9 that we go to Ping Siang or Yo Yi Guan in Guangxi province. And number 3 that is the truck go to Yunnan province to Mohan. Mueang La, CIQ, yeah. And in this case, we have to seal at the warehouse by our quarantine officer. And after that, we send our PQ document or phytosanitary certificate document to CIQ Yo Yi Guan or Mohan. Yeah, that is our arrangement. Highway to China. This is how we inspect at the warehouse before export. This is our inspector to go to inspect at the warehouse and seal before export. Yeah, this is our seal. And in China, they have to be sealed like this also when they bring their fruit along this route. Yeah. This is how we transport our product to China. That is our big market. Thank you very much.